Hello everyone, Assalamu alaikum. In this video, we are going to talk about the temporomandibular joint, that is the TMJ. It is a very important topic, so make sure you watch this video carefully. So focus on the name temporomandibular. Here, temporo means temporal bone and mandibular means the mandible, obviously. So this joint is present between the temporal and the mandible bone. Okay, if you see this diagram here, you can clearly spot this temporal bone. And here is the mandible. So as you can see here, the mandible is kind of fitting in the temporal bone and making a joint that is known as the temporomandibular joint or simply the TMJ. If you talk about its type, it is a condylar variety of synovial joint. To understand this condylar variety, see this diagram of the mandible. So if we see this bone here, this is the condylar process. This process is fitted in the temporal bone making the TMJ. We say that this joint is of condylar variety because condyle articulates here. Hope you understood. Now let's see the articulating surfaces. Here we can see the articulating surface clearly. In the upper surface, we have the temporal bone. Also, we can see this fossa in the temporal bone. This fossa is the mandibular fossa or the glenoid fossa. So here in this fossa, the condyle of the mandible articulates. So upper articulating surface is formed by the mandibular fossa of temporal bone and the lower articulating surface is formed by the condylar process of the mandible. Okay, so let's talk about its ligaments. So total four ligaments are present here. One is fibrous capsule which covers the joint. Second is the lateral temporomandibular ligament that is present laterally between the temporal bone and the mandible bone. These two are the main ligaments. Now, apart from these two main ligaments, we have two more accessory ligaments. If we see the joint from the posterior part, we can see this ligament here. This is the stylomandibular ligament, which is present between the stylet process and the mandible. And just above the stylomandibular ligament, we have one more ligament here, that is the sphenomandibular ligament, that is attached from the sphenoid bone to the mandible bone. Appreciate here how these names represent the origin and the attachment. Now let's discuss the articular disc. To understand this, let's focus on this diagram. Now if you see here, we have the head of the mandible bone. Here we have our temporal bone. And between these two articulating surfaces, we have this disc here. Okay, this is the articulating disc. Now the articular disc divides the joint into an upper and a lower compartment. The upper compartment permits gliding movement and the lower compartment allows rotary as well as gliding movement. Remember this. Now, if you look at this disc closely, it has a concavo-convex superior surface and a concave inferior surface. And at the periphery of the disc, you can see that it is attached to the fibrous capsule. We can divide this disc into various regions. We have anterior region, anterior thick band, intermediate region, posterior thick band, and bilaminar region. The bilaminar region contains venous plexuses. What is the function of this disc? It helps in reducing friction between the articulating surfaces and also acts as a shock absorber. It helps in lubrication of the joint. Now let's jump on to the relations of the TMJ. Anteriorly, it is related to the lateral pterygoid muscle, mesenteric nerve and vessels. Posteriorly, we have the parotid gland, external auditory meatus, superficial temporal vessels, auriculotemporal nerve. Its medial side is present with spine of sphenoid, sphenomandibular ligament, auriculotemporal nerve, cauda tympani nerve, middle meningeal artery. Laterally, it is related to the skin, fascia, parotid gland, facial nerve. Superiorly, middle cranial fossa is present and inferiorly, maxillary artery and vein is present. Now, what about the nerve supply, blood supply and the lymphatic supply here? It is supplied by the auriculotemporal nerve and mesenteric nerve. It receives branches from superficial temporal artery and maxillary artery and it drains into the upper cervical lymph nodes. Okay, now let's discuss the movements of temporomandibular joint. So its movement include depression, that is opening of the mouth, elevation means closing of the mouth, protrusion, that is protraction of the chin, and retrusion, that is the retraction of the chin, and lateral or side-to-side movement during chewing or grinding, you know. If you have seen a video on muscles of mastication, you can easily understand these movements. Also, in complete denture, prosthodontics, we have very elaborately covered the mandibular movements. Now, if you want to feel the movements of your TMJ, what you can do, you can palpate it using your finger. Keep your finger at the pre-auricular joint or into the external auditory meatus. And the movements of the joint can be divided into upper compartment movement and the lower compartment movements. The upper compartment movement means the movement that is occurring between the upper articular surface and the articular disc. And the lower compartment movement means those occurring between the disc and the head of the mandible. Remember that in the forward movement, the movement occurs in the meniscotemporal compartment, that is the upper compartment. When you open your mouth slightly, the movement happens in the lower compartment. But if you open your mouth wide, the movement happens in the upper compartment. What happens in side-to-side movement? For example, if we have the head of the right side gliding forward, the head of one side will glide forward, but the head of the other side will merely rotate on a vertical axis. Now, which muscles produce which kind of movement? Now, depression is brought about by the lateral pterygoid muscle. Elevation is brought about by the masseter, anterior vertical, middle oblique fibers of the temporalis, and the medial pterygoid muscle of both the sides. These are also known as anti-gravity muscles. It can be a viva question. Protrusion happens by lateral and medial pterygoids and superficial oblique fibers of masseter. Retraction is done by posterior horizontal fibers of temporalis and deep vertical fibers of masseter. Now, in lateral or side-to-side movement, imagine that you are chewing from your left side. Okay. Now, if you chew from the left side, that movement will be taking place with the help of the right lateral pterygoid, right middle pterygoid, which push the chin to the left side. Then the left muscles will activate, the left temporalis, the anterior fibers of it, left masseter, the deep fibers of masseter, will chew the food. Now let's discuss the clinical anatomy. Dislocation of mandible is seen during the excessive opening of the mouth. Any injury like overclosure or malocclusion can cause derangement of the articular disc. Now during any operations in the TMJ, the seventh nerve and auriculotemporal nerve should be preserved with care. What is the seventh nerve? That's a question for you. Now let's summarize. TMJ is a synovial joint of the condylar variety present between the temporal and the mandible bone. Upper articulating surface is formed by the mandibular fossa or glenoid fossa of the temporal bone, and the lower articulating surface is formed by the condylar process of the mandible. We have total four ligaments that are fibrous capsule, lateral temporomandibular ligament, sphenomandibular ligament, and stylomandibular ligament. It is supplied by auriculotemporal nerve and mesenteric nerve, and it drains into the upper cervical lymph nodes. Now, in clinical anatomy, we talked about dislocation of mandible and derangement of the articular disc. These topics will be dealt in detail as we move to other subjects, so don't worry about these. Now, important questions include, describe TMJ under following: type, articulating surfaces, ligaments, movements, nerve supply, and blood supply, and write short note on the movements of the TMJ. So I hope you found this video helpful. I think you should revise this video again because it is very important. It can be asked in viva also as a short note and a long note. So I'll see you in the next video. Take care. Allah Hafiz.